It's pomegranate season here in the low desert, and I could not be more excited. Pomegranates are a great tree to add to your landscape. The heat-loving and drought-tolerant pomegranate trees are especially well-suited to grow in some places like Arizona, California, and Texas. In today's video, I'm going to share my best tips for growing pomegranates. If we haven't met before, my name's Angela from Growing in the Garden, and I love to share garden inspiration and helpful tips so you can be successful growing your own garden. One great thing about growing pomegranates is they are very adaptable to the amount of space that you have to give them. Pomegranates can be grown as a large shrub if you just allow it to grow and don't prune it, or it can also be trained into a multi-trunk tree. Pomegranate trees can grow between 12 and 20 feet tall and wide. If you have enough room to allow them to grow, you'll have a nice tree. But the nice thing about pomegranates is you can prune it back for size. If you don't have quite that much space for your pomegranate tree to grow, you can definitely prune it. You can prune it while it's dormant, once it loses its leaf, and you can also prune it lightly throughout the year. Pomegranate trees are tough and they aren't super picky about when and how you prune them. There are several different varieties of pomegranates. When choosing which type to grow, take into consideration your location. There are some types of pomegranate that will grow well in zones as cold as zone 7. Keep that in mind when you're trying to decide which type of pomegranate tree to plant. It's also important to know what color your fruit is when it's ripe and what color the arrows will be when they're ripe. It's also important to know about what time of year your type of pomegranate tree is ripe. So that way you know when to start looking for those arrows to be ripe. So choose a variety that's suited to your taste buds and your climate. But most types will grow well here in the low desert of Arizona and other hot climates. The best time to plant a pomegranate tree is either in the spring or the fall. When you're planting a pomegranate tree, the most important thing to remember is that pomegranates need plenty of sunlight, at least 6 hours, 8 is even better. And the great thing about pomegranate trees is they don't mind full sun. There's not many plants that can say they don't mind full Arizona afternoon sun. And pomegranates are one of those plants. They will be happiest if you put them in an area with lots of sunlight. Not enough sunlight for pomegranate trees will mean fewer blossoms and fewer fruits. So keep that in mind as you choose which area to plant your pomegranate tree in. Pomegranate trees will tolerate just about any type of soil, even alkaline soil, as long as there is good drainage, as long as those roots don't just sit in water. In cooler climates, plant a pomegranate tree with a western exposure or next to a block wall. That will allow that pomegranate tree to thrive even in a little bit cooler zone. When it's time to plant your pomegranate tree, simply dig a hole as deep as the potted pomegranate tree and a few times wider so that those roots have loosened soil to climb out into. Put the pomegranate tree in the hole and then fill it back in with native soil. There's no need to amend that soil around the pomegranate. You want to encourage those roots to branch out into surrounding areas and go deep. Like anything, a pomegranate tree is going to need a little bit more attention when it's first planted, just until it gets established. Give it plenty of water and don't allow it to dry out those first few weeks or even month or so after you've planted to make sure that that tree is nice and established. Once that tree is established, deep, infrequent waterings are best, and pomegranates will tolerate a little bit of drought, so they are a pretty tough tree. The best way to fertilize pomegranate trees is just as they leaf out in early spring, apply a large dose of compost to that area and water it in well. That will be plenty of fertilizer for that fruit tree. Pomegranate trees don't require a lot of fertilization to grow really well. Just before the pomegranate tree leaves out in the spring, it's also a good idea to prune your pomegranate tree. Pomegranate trees can be pruned for size or for shape. And you also want to pay attention to the crossing branches and prune out any of those crossing branches so your pomegranate tree can grow nice and healthy. While the tree is young, it's often a good idea to thin the fruit on the pomegranate tree. That keeps that heavy fruit from breaking some of those younger branches. One thing I've noticed about my pomegranate tree is it's often one of the later trees to leaf out each spring. So you might think, is my tree dead? But don't worry, it's not dead. It's pretty hard to kill a pomegranate tree. Be patient and it will have plenty of leaves and even blossoms before you know it. One of my favorite things about pomegranate trees is the fall color that they provide. Just after the time the pomegranates are harvested, the pomegranate leaves turn a beautiful yellow. Pomegranate trees add beautiful color to our winter landscape. Pomegranate trees are hardy to about 10 degrees, which is much cooler than we normally get here in the low desert, so frost really isn't a problem for the pomegranate trees. If your climate gets much colder than 10 degrees in the winter, consider growing pomegranates in a container or looking for an especially hardy type of pomegranate. If you have an unusually cold winter and temperatures get way below 10 degrees and your pomegranate tree is not leafing out in the spring, that frost may have killed it. If you do have really low temperatures, give the pomegranate tree some time and wait and see if any of the branches leaf out, and then you can remove the wood that has died and leave those branches that didn't have any frost damage. Pomegranate trees begin flowering at a young age, but they often don't hold on to that fruit until they're about 3 years old. So if you have a young pomegranate tree and you're worried that you're getting blossoms but no fruit, just be patient. A lot of times the young pomegranates will drop those blossoms, and then as the fruit tree matures, that fruit will begin to develop. And you should see substantial fruit production almost every year from your pomegranate tree. If you're not getting fruit on your pomegranate tree, some things to look out for are too much water, too much fertilization, and not enough sunlight. Those three factors can cause the yield to be less on your pomegranate tree. Cross-pollination with another type of pomegranate tree usually isn't required, but having more than one pomegranate tree often encourages both trees to be more fruitful. So a question I'm often asked is, how can I tell if my pomegranate tree is ripe? One really important way to know when your pomegranate tree is ripe is to know what kind of pomegranate tree you have and what ripe means for that type of pomegranate tree. Some varieties of pomegranates are white inside, and so if you're waiting for them to turn red, they won't ever turn red. So know what type of pomegranate tree you have and about the time that they get ripe. And then the best way is to try one and see. You can also look for a few different things on the pomegranate itself, and that will give you a few clues. The fruits will lose a little bit of their shine as they get riper. The ridges inside the pomegranate will also be more pronounced as that fruit develops. It may even begin to crack a little bit as that fruit grows larger inside. So those are things to look for. And if you're seeing a lot of bird activity with your pomegranates, you can bet that they're beginning to be ripe because somehow those birds know exactly when they're ripe. If you think the pomegranates might be ready, pick one and find out. Pomegranates will stay ripe on the tree for a week or two, maybe even three, but it is best to pick that fruit once it's ripe rather than have the fruit split and then the wildlife tend to find that fruit right away. When you're harvesting a pomegranate, it's often best to clip the stem. Sometimes the fruit will come right off, but you can also damage the fruit a little bit. So clip those stems on those ripe pomegranates, and that makes them a little bit easier to harvest. If your pomegranate is beginning to split, that can be caused by a few different things. Pomegranates left too long on the tree begin to split, and also wide fluctuations in moisture will cause the pomegranates to split as well. So my least favorite aspect of growing pomegranates are the leaf-footed bugs. If you notice the inside of your fruit is rotten, it's often because the leaf-footed bugs have gotten to that fruit. If you see a bug that looks like a squash bug, or lots of bugs that look like squash bugs on your fruit, those are leaf-footed bugs, and they're a very common pest for the pomegranate trees. Leaf-footed bugs have piercing, sucking mouthparts that suck the juices from ripe fruit. Those mouthparts also inject bacteria into the fruit. Here are a few things that I've found to be most effective managing leaf-footed bugs. Number one, learn what leaf-footed bugs look like in all stages. Learn what the eggs look like, what the nymphs look like, and what the adults look like. And whenever you see them in any stage, get them off your tree. Discard those leaves, squish those bugs. The nymph stage is actually the one stage that it is easiest to kill them with something like neem oil. One important way to prevent damage from leaf-footed bugs next year is to be sure to clean up all the fruit from this year. Leaf-footed bugs will often nest in the fallen fruit or even fruit on the tree. Clean up all the fallen fruit and all the fruit on the tree to help prevent heavy infestations of leaf-footed bugs the following year. Once that fruit is ready and you want to get to this tasty arils inside, take the time to learn how to harvest the arils because they really are delicious, and there are a few methods that make it very simple and very easy to harvest those arils. Here's my favorite way to harvest the arils inside a pomegranate. Score each ridge of the pomegranate with a knife and break it open. Hold it in your hand with the peel side up over a bowl of water. Hit the rind with a flat wooden spoon, and the seeds should fall into the bowl and leave just a few seeds in the rind. Hopefully you were able to learn a thing or two about growing pomegranates. Thank you so much for watching.